Well, my friends, today I'm going to test this beautiful and really beauty TUS9, Sansui TUS9 tuner from 1982. And I already reviewed. If you want to know more about this amplifier, you have to go back in my videos and then you see the review of the amplifier. I do this separate. I think, yeah, this thing deserves a separate review, the tuner, because I think it's one of the most beautiful tuners. I think one of the first tuners Samsung made with a digital display, you know. 1981, 1982 was the time when tuners did the step, yeah, from analog to digital. And as you can see over here, my friend, over here, I have one of the most beautiful tuners Samsung ever made. This one was from which year, Simon?
1972, 1971, I don't know, somewhere around that time.
74.
No, I think it was earlier than that.
Okay, but this tuner is an analog tuner, yeah? And this one is also the Akai is an analog tuner. And so, the period from analog tuners was finished because the digital tuner was so much cheaper to build, you know, you didn't need that big tuner board, and so it was cheaper to build a tuner. But even also in those digital tuners, there was a big difference. One digital tuner was not the other digital tuner. I often test here tuners with just a wire. In the back of this tuner is connected just a wire, so you can only receive local stations. But because I test this way, you have exactly the image how strong the reception is from a certain tuner. And some tuners with just a wire on the same spot can only receive one or two stations in stereo, and this one is not the strongest tuner. I had stronger tuners before, but the sound is very nice from this tuner, that's first. The looks are very nice, and this thing is a special tuner because I'm going to show you the price list. I'm going to show you the price list. Here you see on the bottom, yes, here you see that this tuner had a price from over here, TUS9, where my thumb is, 1179 guilders, and this shop sold them for 999, so you can say 1000 guilders, so that means 450 euro for alone the tuner, and that was their most expensive tuner they sold at that in this period. As you can see, you also see the AUD9 I earlier reviewed over here, the price list. That amplifier what you see over here had a price from 1500 euro. But the guy I'm gonna show you, the guy got an extra allowance. He only paid 951. You can see the price here, 951 for the tuner and 1399 for the amplifier. So the total set price was 2350 for this set. That's the complete set. Let me try to focus better. Yeah. And he bought it 28th of January in 1984. So this set is now 35 years, huh?
Mm-hmm.
35 years, exactly 35 years. 35 years and 3 weeks, and 3 weeks. So the thing is, you have more on things on?
Yeah, booklets.
I have the complete. I have the complete booklet from this rare tuner, good tuner, and it had a 2 years guarantee, and well, it have batteries in the back to not to lose the memory from your station when you plug out the electricity cord. Yes, so that's very nice. And also it have this strip. I'm gonna show you this strip. And what is the meaning of this strip, Simon?
This strip goes inside of the tuner.
Over here,
huh? Yeah, you can record married stations on it. But you can
it goes like this on the inside?
Yeah, but yeah. Only 10, so you gave you an extra one, so you can record 20, but then you have to change the strip.
Oh, okay, so
yeah.
Normally you have 1 to 10 presets.
Yeah.
And because of this extra strip, you have 10 presets extra.
Yeah, and in the 90s you had a plus 10 and you could calculate 20 in it, but it's because it's early.
But I never see this system before. This was unique, I think.
Yeah.
So this is that's why I think this tuner deserves more credit, only because of the batteries in the back. I remember, my friends, this tuner was sold in 1984, but it came out in 1981.
Yeah.
So in 1981, the battery pack in the back was unique, or maybe not unique, but you could not find that in most tuners. And this thing made it even uniquer because of this strip, you know, you place in the back. And what more this thing also have is the looks. I mean, it have a, let me see, it is a little bit dirty here, yeah, but it is a mint one, almost mint. But I love the looks from this tuner. It have a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful looks, matching very nice with the amplified. It's a beautiful match, and only because of the looks and the extras this tuner came, I think the price in 1984, the price 1,000 guilder or 450 euro was a reasonable price for this tuner. And now you can find it for how much?
Between 100 and 200.
Only the tuner?
Yeah.
I think that's a little bit too much, but okay. I think the set is about 375. But okay, I'm gonna test the tuner. You can see over here, it's like the switch, aux, tuner. It's on the tuner sound, and this is how it sounds. And as I earlier described it, this is only a wire. A little wire inside, speaker wire, not even a tuner wire, speaker wire, for the reception, yeah?
Mooi, hè? En ja. Dat vind ik echt heel goed, want dat betekent dat het echt zo klein is dat één gemeente kan zeggen, weet je, wij willen gewoon een kerncentrale.
Nee, Mark, dat is helemaal niet goed, want daar wordt het gewoon gebruikt als excuus om...
Ja, local stations, my friends, so you will hear Dutch voices.
Natuurlijk vaker. Maar serieus, er wordt heel veel gedaan, er wordt heel veel ontwikkeld. Maar goed, het blijft ook nadelen hebben, zoals alle vormen van energie na...
And what you hear is of course the HECO statements, those white big speakers.
Er komt nauwelijks CO2 bij vrij, maar het is niet duurzaam, want je moet iets uit de grond halen om het te verstoken.
Ja, zeker. En je hebt kernafval en dat zal met die nieuwe generatie, als het allemaal goed komt, veel minder zijn en veel minder langdurig of langjarig. Zal voor een deel ook weer andere afval kunnen verbranden in die centrale, dus er zijn ook wel weer voordelen aan. Maar goed, dan krijgen we een discussie, wat heeft geen nadelen en wat weeg je dan zwaarder? Nou, de mensen blijkbaar in deze opiniepeiling... meer mensen zijn enthousiast dan vorig jaar.
Ja, ja, dan zijn ze meer, maar het zijn inderdaad nog, het is nog lang geen meerderheid. Als het 22% is, laten we het afronden, ongeveer een kwart van Nederland die nu voor is, dan is het drie kwart tegen of heeft geen mening.
Nou, als die ontwikkeling klopt... Ja, dat is een aardig. Je hebt gezongen met Marco
Borsato. Ja, gezongen. Ja, kijk, je moet het wel afwegen en dus zo
Well, in a way, most of you, me, yeah, I'm not most of you, but me, myself, I'm a tuner lover, and most of the time I only listen to one station. Sometimes I change for another station, but two or three stations I only listen to normally. So you know, I always have my favorite station, and I think most of you. So I think 10 presets is enough. More than enough, but yeah, if you want, you have this extra strip, and this I just explained to you, but the sound from this thing is really fantastic.
Laat me varen, laat me waaien, en doe dan maar.
I'm not sure if this tuner, I don't like standalone tuners, you know, if I have a tuner, it is always a match with that amplifier. That's what I like. I have over there, that Onkyo with a preamplifier. I have the matching tuner also, but the thing is, I think for the aesthetics with that tuner on it, it will be too high. So, and now I use that Chrome Cast Audio, and soon I will invest in a better streaming device with a better DAC. Not sure which one. I'm still looking and thinking and talking with people around me which DAC is the best, which streaming device is the best for me, you understand? So not sure which one to buy. That Chromecast Audio, is not really, you know. No, I'm not satisfied with that thing. So, I'm using that thing now at the moment. So, for the time being, but not another thing I will have next year. So, I'm thinking about a better streaming device. And then I don't need a tuner anymore, because I have internet radio. So, why would I still use a tuner?
Better sound quality.
Better sound quality. Yeah! Is that really a better sound quality if you
have... I talked with a famous guy, for the audio business, a famous guy who repairs only tuners.
Yeah.
And he recalibrates them and he measures things and so. And the quality of a FM, of a good FM radio, is way, way, way higher than any internet radio.
Really?
Yeah. CubeJack, just look at the site.
Also, even if you have a streaming device with a very good DAC.
Yeah, because the radio is still shit on the internet. Because you can have really good DAC, but the sound quality in the source is not good.
So there ain't any tuner stations with high quality...
No, internet stations, not no. No. And yes. I also don't like DAC. Or we mean... what was it? DAB. DHB.
So, okay. Then probably if that's the case, if I heard, I will connect that tuner, that Onkyo tuner. I have the complete set, my guys. I have that CD player. No, I don't think I will use that CD player anymore. I have that CD player, but that one I will not use. I have a cassette deck. That one is now in reparation with John De Recht. He plays some new belts because Simon do not have knowledge from, well,
no, he
has
knowledge,
but he hates repairing reel-to-reel decks and cassette decks. He hates repairing those things, and also CD players, eh?
And CD players is not a problem, but also reel-to-reel is not a problem, but cassette decks, I don't like the sound of a cassette deck.
But okay, I have that cassette deck in reparation because it is a very good cassette deck. It is the T, De R1 2800, so that's a very good 3-head cassette deck. And the only thing what is wrong with that cassette deck it is that it needs a new rubber belt for the play. And that's why I thought, well, give the thing a reparation, sell it, resell it, because I will not use it. But now Simon tells me that the tuner sound is not as nice.
We can test that.
I will test it. I will test the tuner sound from that tuner, that Onkyo tuner, because it is a mint one. It is a mint one. So I will test it out vs a good streaming device, a very good streamer, a good DAC, not the Chromecast audio. Okay, the Chromecast audio was for me, or is still for me, a learning device, you know, how to work with wireless music, streaming music, and I must say I like the system, but I don't like the quality of that Chromecast audio. They are much better, of course, more expensive devices out there, and so I have to make a good choice. You know, I cannot buy something for 300 euro and regret it after a month. Oh, I bought the wrong thing. So I always doing my homework very long and very good before I take a step, you know, the step to buy it. You know, there are some guys who see something, oh, that's a nice review. Next day they are in the shop or they order it online. I'm not in this way. I will do my homework to see which kind of streaming device they are around. Well, under a certain price, of course, because I have a limit, and I think my limit is about 500 euro for a streaming device. And but if I'm going to pay 500 euro for a streaming device, it should be very good. And if I cannot find a very good streaming device with a very good DAC, because the DAC is important for me, because that thing translates your sound, then probably I will buy it, but I have a limit for 500 euro. I will not invest more as that. The Chromecast audio is online for well, they stopped producing them. You can now have that Yamaha streaming device for 120 euro, but I see them often online, second hand, on Dutch eBay, so that means it is not a very good device. People resell this thing because they are not satisfied. Every week somebody is reselling that Yamaha cheap streaming device. It costs 120 euro. They sell it second hand, and you can find it for about 80 euro second hand, you know, at the moment. But that's very cheap, but because they come online so often second hand, I think they are not good. Something is wrong with these things. The sound is not what it can be. You understand what I mean? I mean, can be. I think if I invest a little bit more, maybe 100 more, 200, 300 more, up to a max to 500, maybe I can have that good streaming deck. But yeah, I just heard from Simon that a tuner is always better. I did not knew that, so knowing that now, I probably will place the tuner. Not sure how it will look, because I don't like this audio table too high. But okay, if the sound with that tuner is better, I'm a tuner man, I'm a tuner guy, then probably I will going to use that tuner in future. But for this tuner, well, I like sets, and in combination with this amplifier, it is a beautiful set. The sound is good. You just heard some. Well, let me see a little bit more. Somebody say a name.
ambtenaar niet. Die kan helemaal geen goede keuzes maken over wat goede bedrijven zijn, wat niet, hoe je bedrijf managt. Dat kan alleen het bedrijfsleven.
Sound is very nice, my friends. Very nice. A very pleasant way of touching, you know, to control this thing. And once you have this taste in the memory, the thing is working smooth. It's very easy to find. I'm going to show you. Let me see, 91, 95. Let me see which stations I have here. 1, 4, 2, 1. Okay. Let me show you how the thing works.
Al tientallen jaren bestaan, bestonden in Delft. De velspuiters, de bootshapers, die shoppers, die stonden ermee. M.2 treft carnaval in Delft.
So this one I just placed in the memory, very easy to you know, so on the next station, you know, drilling down. Yeah.
En er zijn natuurlijk steeds meer mensen die op bepaald moment actief willen zijn.
Maar
ik
heb
een
probleem aan de rug.
En die zeggen,
jongen,
doe ik het eigenlijk
al? Maar het is
the same.
Nou, je hebt to push it up because it goes down. En it goes up again. And then
it oh, het is op the end, oké.
Okay. Yes, we have to push up.
Anyway, in case you push on memory and the station where you want to store it. And then it is in the memory. This simple. I didn't even use the manual to figure this out. Everybody can do it. I mean, most tuners work in this way, you know, tuning memory, boost the preset station, and there it comes, and it stays in this tuner because of the batteries inside. I'm not sure, probably the batteries are completely dried out, so you need to replace these batteries to function good, you know, to have that function. Because once you take out the electricity, then it loses the complete memory, you know, but not in this one. If the batteries in the back, you place new batteries in the back, and they need new batteries, I think, eh? Yeah. Then it's not a problem. This, the memory stays inside, yeah, okay? Well, this was a review of this beautiful 1981, from 1981. This device is from 1984, but they start selling it in 1981. Beautiful device. It was an expensive tuner. You can sometimes I see them for even for €50 on Dutch eBay. But yeah, probably they are damaged. And this one doesn't have a scratch. Only a scratch on top here on the wooden top. You know, with a scratch. But it is a beautiful thing. I had it for a while. I used it upstairs, you know, as a test device when somebody comes to buy speakers from me. And I use this thing because, you know why I use this thing? Because most speakers do not have a very nice low end, and the amplifier goes deeper, warmer as most amplifiers, so the sound of normal speaker, I mean, I don't mean my Heiko don't need this amplifier, but normal speakers who don't go so low sounded much lower with this amplifier. That's why I have many amplifiers, many receivers, but that's why I always use this thing, you know, because everything sounded more nicer when you have, especially when you have speakers who don't go that low, you know, you place everything on neutral, but it still goes deeper than most amplifiers. Well, this was the review. Thanks for watching. Put your thumbs up, and for now I say ciao.